great pleasure to welcome back to our dojo Shihan Miguel Ibarra from the New York Budokan Yamabushi Jujutsu School. He is a 7th degree black belt in Jujutsu and a 2nd degree black belt in Aikido Jujutsu. He's also a supervisor for the Fugitive Warrant Division of the Probation Department in New York City. And he's going to share some of his experiences and techniques as far as law enforcement officers go. So I'm going to turn the clinic now over to Shihan Miguel Ibarra.
Hi. So since I already gave you, you know, basically my background, just a little bit more. My job consists only of making arrests, not initial arrests. These are guys that are convicted already, so they're going. Whether they want to or not, they're going to go. There's no question about it. No rights have to be read, nothing. I got a warrant. I'm going to break your door down. If you don't open it, I'm going to take you with me. So basically, my experience in extricating these people from different locations, taking them into custody, differs a bit from an initial arrest where you have to be a little more careful. You know, you got to go through all your probable cause and all that other stuff. I already know the guy's going with me, so it's just a matter of extending the invitation with either myself and one other person, or myself and 6 or 7 other persons, and if need be, 10 or 15 more, which has happened. The techniques, I'm primarily a martial artist. I've been doing this for 24 years, going on 25. So I'm a martial artist first, law enforcement second. So I rely a lot on my martial arts training. And it's not just in technique, just as a something, you know, mental to think about. It's not just the techniques that you do or that you learn. The techniques don't mean anything. Okay, you could have, I could be a 24th Dan in Killer Ryu. Okay, and it doesn't mean anything if you don't have it up here, and if you don't have it in here, my instructor likes to call it something in Spanish, which I won't translate, but basically it turns out to be guts. Okay, the techniques in themselves do not work. Okay, there is no technique that you will learn that works. You make it work. Okay? Nobody, people can come in and tell you all kinds of stories, all kinds of, you know, fantasies. There is nothing, you guys have been on the streets, a lot of you, most of you, right? You know, you come up against this little old boy who doesn't want to go with you, you can know anything. If you can't take him down in here, you're never going to take him with you. So, if all you know in your life is one technique, and you perfect that technique, but you know that you're going to make that technique work all the time in the streets, that's what you need. And to be able to know when to back away and when not to back away. We never advocate, you know, going into full-out confrontations with anybody because it doesn't make any sense. Always try to talk your way out of it. Use the nice way, and then if that all else fails, then hey, you have a party. Okay? You can stand up and relax. As far as I'm concerned, the seminar started. This is much more relaxed than a regular martial arts seminar. You might want to, I don't think anybody here did anything to their wrists. Why don't you, can you get up so they can relax? Just loosen up your wrists a little bit because they'll be working on them for a while. Just do this kind of stuff. You know, twist it around. You know, this kind of stuff here. And just get the blood flowing into those joints and the elbows. And before I forget, I'd like to thank all of you. It's a Saturday morning. Some of you, I understand some of you, you know, just came straight out of work. I really appreciate the fact that you've taken the time on Saturday morning to wake your families to be here with yourself. I'll try to make it worthwhile for you. Okay? I'm going to start off with some basic, I guess you can call it like a kata. Okay? It's a way of practicing some of the locks without any fighting involved that we use. This is Sensei George Acevedo. He's my student, my uchideshi, personal assistant, goes with me everywhere. One of you just stand, and you come up, to here, and the elbow strike here. Just lock up his elbow here. That's one. Okay? Very basic. Okay, we'll do those four. We'll start off from here. Let's pick a partner. Let's come in. Sit simulate a strike, lock up his elbow here. Okay? Just come on. Grab somebody. Do these first, then we'll move into something where you get some action. By the way, if you know how to take falls, you know, let the person you're working with that you know, whatever. If you have no experience in martial arts at all, please let each other know. I don't want you learning how to fall here and then being out of work for 6 months. So if you have no experience in taking falls or taking punishment, let everybody know, okay? Go ahead. These are basic come along type. Sure. Right under the elbow. Get your forearm right under it. See, this is a lot of power. Don't use any power. Just relax. Slip your arm underneath. Relax nice. Put your hand here. Push down and up. Mine is open. There you go.
Hear that?
Okay. He'll go with you anywhere. Unless he's drunk or drugs, in which case he won't be in pain. Guy gives you a hard time, two of you, big guy, two of you take him. Okay? You're going with me. Okay?
Strike is distraction? Or?
Yeah, it's a distraction. It's a distraction. You're not going to double him over. If you do, that's great, because you don't use the other one. Okay? Put your hands aside. Put this right here. Always give yourself some position. Raise it and lower. Raise that one lower.
Small strike? Yeah.
Sure. If you've got a jacket, you've felt anything, grab it. The guy's giving a lot of resistance. You can lower it.
Yeah. Get it up above the elbow.
One second. Remember, there's something I forgot to mention. Just stay where you are. And that's, besides using your minds and having a lot of guts, the techniques on the street, for real street stuff, you're going to have to do this guy in, okay? No one's going to stand there like we're doing here, okay? Just so you know. I don't teach magic, and I don't like people thinking that I'm going to teach you magic. It's not magic. You get into a hassle with somebody, you're going to have to get into it with them. These strikes, little strikes in here, you know, they're just meant as distractions, get his mind off it. But you may have to put this guy, you know, give him a couple of them. You may have to take a few and then put him into this only because of the laws that we're bound by. You know? So in order to do something that's non-deadly, you're going to have to go into it with this guy. You do need power. Okay, contrary to what a lot of people are going to, you know, are expounding and talking about in magazines about how they can teach law enforcement officers to touch a guy's neck and drop a guy. That's great, but I tell you, I haven't met a crack addict yet in the Bronx that I could touch on his neck and drop him, okay? And I haven't met one of these junkies and one of these muggers who plays basketball all day and then decides that he needs dinner money and mugs with the old ladies. I haven't met one of them yet that you can just go, and just drop, okay? It works great in dojos, works great in demonstrations, and, you know, and I'm not saying against people who practice those techniques, but look, you deal with the real world. You're going to need to get into it. You need a little bit of power. You need a little bit of strength along with the techniques. Now, in this case, all these little strikes, this is a distraction. Get his mind off. Get him to relax a little bit. In the street, you may have to knock him around.